In a few moments, we'll begin the 2020 high school sports celebration. These past few months have been extremely challenging, to say the least. All of us have been affected by this crisis in some way, shape, or form. Herricks is a resilient community. We will persevere through the current pandemic. On behalf of the entire athletic department, we would like to wish you well. You are all in our thoughts and in our prayers. Welcome to the annual Herricks High School Sports Night. On behalf of the entire coaching staff and myself, we'd like to express our appreciation to the entire Herricks community. Starting with the parents. Without your dedication and continuous support, we would not be where we are today. We'd also like to thank you for allowing us to be a part of your child's life. For the seniors whose high school sports career has abruptly ended, this is, to say the least, devastating. We cannot convey how sorry we are. You have done an amazing job of representing Herricks. During your journey, you have created many relationships with teammates and coaches that will last a lifetime. You have truly become an amazing person during this path. Now, tonight is a celebration, but it's also a sad day because we're saying goodbye to some very special individuals, most notably our senior athletes. All of you have made this a memorable journey. Your commitment to the athletic program has made Herricks a force to be reckoned with. We applaud your efforts.
And now a few words from our spring coaching staff.
First and foremost, I hope everyone is safe and healthy in these crazy times. Obviously, there was no spring season this year, which is absolutely devastating to all the athletes, especially the seniors. The seniors have done an outstanding job building and continuing the winning tradition of the Herricks baseball program. Your hard work throughout your time has laid the groundwork for continued success in the years to come. Thank you for everything you have done, and you are leaving the program in a better place. I'd like to recognize our senior athletes: David Cabrera, Cole LaRocque, Jake Marciano, Peter Correca, Franco DeMilta, Sean Park, Sal Poliafico, Chris Lamando, Matt Strokia, Virag Shah, Mac Mihalik, and Alex DiGregorio. Please stand to be recognized. I'd also like to recognize the two athletes who will be playing at the next level, Jake Marciano at Galveston College and Peter Correca at Delaware State. Stay safe and stay strong.
Hi everybody, Coach Capasso here. I am the coach of the girls golf team, which unfortunately did not have a season this year. Before I start, I would like to just hope that everybody is staying safe and doing well. The girls golf team had two seniors I would like to acknowledge. The first was Mary O'Connor. Mary was our captain for 2 years in a row, and this year as well, she would have made it a third year. And she is really somebody who has grown on and off the course. She also represented the Herricks girls golf team at the county tournament for the last 2 years. And I think this year would have been a third in a row for her. So I'm sorry that didn't happen for you this season, Mary. But I do want to let you know that it was great coaching you. You were somebody I could rely on to know all the rules, to really put together a solid nine holes every time out there and help some of the younger girls. And I saw that more and more as the years went on. And I even saw it, even though we didn't have a season, I did notice it leading up to this last season as we were in contact. You were organizing group chats and giving me some ideas of different things we could try, which any coach truly appreciates. So Mary, it was a privilege to coach you these last 2 years. And of course, I'm sorry that this third one didn't work out, but please feel free to reach out anytime. The second player I would like to acknowledge is Chloe Chu. And Chloe is the last of the originals. She came to us as a freshman, and that was the first year of Herricks Girls Golf. And I still remember Chloe out there that first round. And the team itself only had five players at the time. We've grown a great deal since then. And Chloe was out there. Three of the girls were seniors, and you had Chloe, who was a freshman. So she didn't really know anyone. And I remember that first time out, you just had a tough time, and you got quite upset. And I didn't know if it was going to work out for you, but you stuck with it that year. You came back to us next year. You were somebody we could rely on. And then you were back again as a junior, and we planned on seeing you again as being, again, somebody in at one of our top golfers that we could always rely on. So I'm sorry we didn't get that senior season in, but it is something that is quite an accomplishment. Starting as a freshman, didn't really know too many people on the, in fact, you didn't really know anyone on the team at the time, and you stuck with it, and any coach would truly appreciate that. So Chloe, thanks for hanging in there. I hope you did learn a little bit of a life lesson with it, just to hang in there and try your best, and you really did accomplish something. So there's something to be said for that. So girls, once again, I just wanted to thank you and wish you good luck, and please reach out to me anytime. Feel free to drop a line, email, message, anytime, and I'll be happy to help you guys out. Good luck.
The 2020 Herricks Boys lacrosse season was primed to be one for the ages. A top 10 preseason seed in Class B, the highest we've ever been projected to finish in that conference in my time here. Returning all our underclassmen that led us to the playoffs in back-to-back years in 2018 and 2019. On paper, the best chance to earn a home playoff game and advance to the quarterfinals. And then it was taken from us. There is probably nothing I can say or do to alleviate the disappointment of our team, especially our senior class. Ultimately, this is a painful reminder that there are more important things in life than lacrosse. Although, it's okay for lacrosse to be important to you and for this to hurt. Our seniors have clearly shown us the importance of lacrosse in their lives. Ashish Multani, we know your passion is football, and you've done everything in your power to earn an impactful role on the gridiron. However, we always appreciate your commitment to us and for doing everything that we've asked. Frank LaPinta, certainly in true growth mindset fashion, you've done everything in your power to find your potential on the lacrosse field. However, watching you grow up since our days together at Herrick Summer Rec, I know you don't let things outside of your control define you, and the ability to advocate for yourself is a far more important skill than anything you'll ever do on the field. Chris Chimenti and Nate Dowd, certainly what a ride it's been since our days together on a very talented Tomahawks travel team, but both of you are maturing as people and as leaders in our program, as well as earning athletic scholarships for lacrosse to play at the NCAA level. We talk all the time about only focusing on what you can control. Ultimately, pandemics are out of our control. All that we can guarantee is your effort. I hope you can find solace in the fact that your effort has put us in position for success this season and beyond. I know it, you know it, we all know it. I want you, perhaps more than any other senior class, to come back and share our success with us. You deserve the credit, even though it has been taken from you. Our 2020 season is a painful reminder that when things get taken from you, you have to move on. But when you move on, you never take things for granted because you never know when a season or anything else in life will be taken from you. You have life to the fullest. If there are more important things than lacrosse now, there will be to look forward to in your future. So be the best person you can be as you move on from us, and we will do the same. Your greatest legacy lies in the men that you will become, surpassing anything you could have done for us on the field as seniors.
Guys, Coach Amatino here, representing girls lacrosse. Miss you guys so much. Coach McLaughlin, Coach Masterson, and I were really upset to find out we weren't going to have our 2020 season. But we're looking forward to next year, working with you girls, coming out strong. So keep up all that hard work over the summer. We want to acknowledge our senior, Kat Antonopoulos. We're going to miss you so much next year. We had such a great time coaching you. You were a pleasure to have on our team. We're going to miss your smile and your silliness and your work ethic and your strong presence on our defense. Just know that you left a mark for us at Herricks and that we love you very much. And we wish you the very best next year. And you're going to love college. For everyone else, we will see you next year in 2021.
Hello, Herricks family. My name is Warren Webster, and I'm the varsity softball coach. Unfortunately, our 2020 softball season has been canceled. My coaching staff and I would like to thank all the girls who went to tryouts, made the teams, as they worked very hard. I especially want to thank my seniors. Over the last 4 years, you seniors have been a pleasure to coach. We won 2 conference titles, moved up a division, and went to the playoffs twice together. I am so very proud of all of you and all that you have accomplished. I want to wish you the best of luck in college. This year's Herricks Highlander seniors are Dina Sikatos, Gracie Bravo, Caitlin Nell, Amanda Bartolotta, Kathleen Ritchie, Gabby Zambell, Lauren Levine, and Rebecca Garcia. We are also very proud to inform the Herricks family that Rebecca has committed to playing softball as a pitcher at Brandeis University in Boston. We wish you the best of luck and all the success in the world, Rebecca. I would also like to thank Diane Passatieri, who is retiring this year. I have learned so much from Diane. She has been a coach at Herricks for more than 20 years. We will miss seeing you on the diamond, and we want to wish you all the happiness moving into the next chapter of life. So swing for the fences, Herricks. Stay strong, stay healthy, and stay safe.
Today we come here to celebrate the Herricks Athletic Program. To me, the spring season is always a very exciting one. The boys' spring track team is always involved with hosting invitationals and participating in special events throughout Nassau County. The team is made up of a tight-knit group of hardworking and dedicated athletes. The athletes enjoy and bond together through tough practices, challenging meets, and of course, singing on the bus ride home. Though this season was cut short, I want to acknowledge the seniors. These athletes have participated on the spring track and field team for the past 4 years and contributed in many ways. The 2020 seniors are Manfred Fong, Riley Kiernan, Ryan Lee, Prit Patel, Bob Patel, Chris Matthew, Jeff Chen, Jared Martin, Alan Abraham, and our manager Vivian Sum. We want to wish you all the best of luck in the future and encourage you to keep in touch.
Hi, on behalf of Coach Gurick and myself, we'd like to honor the girls' 2020 spring track team. Unfortunately, as you know, we lost our season this year, but we would like to take the time to honor our senior athletes and say a fond farewell and thank you very much. We say goodbye to Cushy Montero, Nicole Marakovic, Saloni Patel, and Sherry Shao. We want to thank you for everything you did over these last years and we wish you all the best of luck, and we look forward to being able to do this in person. Thank you.
Hello, Highlanders. I'm Ray Cross, coach of the boys varsity tennis team at Herricks. We're here today to honor our senior players who unfortunately have missed the tennis season due to COVID-19. The team captain, Rohan Gupta, has been a big part of this team since his freshman year. He was slated to be a top singles player in Nassau County this year. Rohan will play tennis in the fall for Washington University in St. Louis, Missouri. We wish him well. Our second senior is Shrub Savani, a very reliable tennis player. Shrub has improved his game each season. And our third senior player is Hubert Zhao, who is also a doubles player. We will miss Hubert's spirit and his love for the game. As we say goodbye to our seniors, we encourage the players who will be back to work on their game over the summer and come back next year ready to go. We wish you all the best, Coach Cross.
Badminton. I miss you all so much, practicing together, working out together, and cheering you on at all of our games. This was such a big year for us, and I know we're all ready for it since we moved up one conference. However, I'm just still so proud of how far we've come as a team, and I know we couldn't have done it without our seniors. So Alicia, Coco, and Gunreet, you all truly deserve to be recognized for the time and effort that you put into our team on the past few years. You're always thinking of ways to make us a better team. And Alicia, I want to especially say that you're always committed. You're always thinking about ways to bond us together. And I'll always remember that. Coco, you're just an insanely hard worker. You always push yourself in practice and challenge yourself at games. And you became a better player for all of your hard work and always exceeded my expectations. And Gunreet, your commitment to the team never wavered. You were always there with a positive attitude and always wearing a smile on your face. And it was contagious. So I hope you're all proud of that, all of the dedication that you put into our team. I truly know that I am.
The male recipient of the Coach's Service Award is a dedicated two-sport athlete. This individual is a true leader amongst his peers. He has a team-first attitude, he's extremely personable, and is generally the first person a teammate or coach turns to for advice or support. He always looks for a way to improve any situation. The male recipient of the 2020 Coach's Service Award is Prit Patel. Motivator and spiritual leader are two words to describe the female recipient of this award. This individual is extremely coachable, is respectful to teammates, opponents, and coaches. She's created an environment where everyone feels they can succeed. The warm manner in which she welcomes and treats all teammates makes her a valuable member of her teams. Simply put, she's a great kid. The female recipient of the 2020 Coach's Service Award is Grace Bravo.
The Erwin Gerung Scholar Athlete Award was established in 1989 by a Herricks alumnus that was a football player and an exemplary student. The donor expressed a strong desire to honor his football coach, who coached the team for over 30 years and to 100 victories. The recipient of this special award made a strong contribution on the football field while maintaining high academic standards. Academically, this player is off the charts. He took a rigorous course load, including 11 honors or AP level courses. He earned a GPA of 3.92 and a 34 on the ACTs. On the field, he was everything that a coach wanted in an athlete. Hardworking, dedicated. His 10 catches, 200 yards, 4 touchdowns led the way against Almont in one of our biggest victories of the season. All-County honorable mention. Academic All-Conference. National Football Foundation Scholar Athlete, and now the 2019-20 recipient of the Erwin Garong Scholar Athlete Award is Chris Jarazunas. I hope this video finds you well, safe, and healthy. These are certainly very difficult times, but I'm certain we'll get through this together. It is my honor to present to you as the head football coach of your Herricks Highlanders. I'd like to thank our varsity football staff, Todd Goodwin, Tommy Graff, and Eric Goldberg, as well as our JV staff, Rob Bianco and Warren Webster. Our middle school staff, Joe Welsh, Mike Lisak, John Lavis, and Larry Sinicori. We have such a committed and dedicated staff, I'm truly blessed to be working beside you. I'm extremely proud of our Highlanders. Day in and day out, our Highlanders represented Herricks in a respectful way. Respectful in the way we carried ourselves throughout Nassau County, and respectful in our play on the field. Despite not meeting our season goals of making the playoffs, your Highlanders certainly have a lot to be proud of. These young men brought great energy and left it all on the field, whether it was at practice or in games, which is how we were able to achieve some impressive wins this year, including victories against Elmont, Long Beach, and Belmore JFK. Some firsts for our program as we continually take steps to meeting our goals and making the playoffs. These accomplishments were only possible through the leadership of our seniors, captains Chris Jarazunas, Cole LaRock, Reese Kamarazaman, and Nate Dowd, and our seniors, David Cabrera, Sal Pagliafico, Brandon Aguilar, Jacob George, Jake David, Chris Lamondo, Thanasi Mamias, Frank Cangelosi, Denny Zhang, Ash Multani, Matt Polo, Patrick Thornton, and Brian Singh. The following seniors earned postseason awards from the coaches of Nassau County. Chris Jarazunas was named All-County Honorable Mention, Academic All-Conference, and National Football Foundation Scholar Athlete. Cole LaRock was named All-County Honorable Mention. Sal Pagliafico, Long Island Association of Football Officials, Unsung Hero. Cole LaRock, Chris Jarazunas, and David Cabrera represented Herricks in the exceptional senior game played on Thanksgiving morning. I'm also proud to share that Cole LaRock and Sal Pagliafico will be continuing their football careers at Fairleigh Dickinson University next year. Our most improved player is someone who quietly brought it every day. He's as tough as they come and as reliable as we've had. We can count on him to come up big in big spots, especially at that corner position. I'm proud to announce that our most improved player is Brandon Aguilar. Our most valuable player is someone that has been part of our program since Coach Graff was playing quarterback for us. He's pound for pound one of the toughest and grittiest players that I've had the pleasure to coach. All-County, honorable mention. He was invited to play in the exceptional senior game. He will be continuing his football career at Fairleigh Dickinson University. Our MVP is Cole LaRock. So I want to take this time to thank everyone who came to our games and supported our program. It really means a lot to me as the football coach, and I know it meant a lot to our guys as well. Thank you.
Tonight we come here to celebrate the Herricks High School athletic program. I can't help but be a little sad because we are saying goodbye to our seniors. The seniors helped set the tone throughout the season. Their hard work and dedication led the way for the rest of the team. Please join me in recognizing our seniors, Joanne Johnson, Saloni Patel, Sherry Shao, Karina Eng, Luke Phillip, Riley Kiernan, Chris Matthew, Jeff Chen, and Ryan Lee. Seniors, we want to thank you for all you have done for our team over the last 4 years and wish you the best of luck in the future. This season was an exciting one. The team competed in a tough conference. Each week, our athletes raced some of the best competition that Nassau County had to offer. We also attended the Great Neck South Invitational, where many of our athletes earned awards based on their performances in their races. The team also made a return to the prestigious Manhattan College Cross Country Invitational in Van Cortlandt Park. Here, our athletes competed against some of the top runners in the country. Several of our athletes also earned awards. The 2019 cross country team was also a scholar athlete team. This year, the Most Improved Player Award goes to two athletes who were new to our sport. They took their love of running track and field and decided to continue by running cross country with us this fall. They worked very hard and earned varsity spots on the roster. I'd like to congratulate the 2019 Cross Country Most Improved Player Awards to Barath and Harsha. Simply put, our MVP did it all. These two athletes were some of the top runners throughout our season. They were leaders who led by example and were positive role models to all our athletes. Their teammates looked up to them throughout the season and showed them respect. I want to congratulate our 2019 MVP Award winners, Rhea Rasquina and Riley Kiernan. Thank you.
Hey guys, Coach Capasso here as coach of boys varsity golf in the fall. Before I do get started, I just wanted to send a message that I hope everybody is staying safe. We miss seeing you guys around the building and on the fields, and hopefully we get back soon. In the fall, the boys golf team had another successful season. We improved to 7-5 and came within a few strokes of being 8-4. I believe this is something we could build on as all of our starters are returning next season. I would like to congratulate the following players for their individual achievements. Dylan Kim was All-County. Kyle Hunter was All-County Honorable Mention, and he also received the Coach's Award again in the fall. And in addition, Adith Hegde and Ian Varghese finished in the top 50 in Nassau and qualified to play in the county tournament. The player that I would like to acknowledge as the most improved player is Ian Varghese. He's someone who had the third best average on the team, and he is also someone that continues to develop into a leader in the classroom and on the course. Keep up the good work, Ian. And the player that I would like to acknowledge as the most valuable player was Dylan Kim. Like I mentioned earlier, Dylan was all county, and he had the best scoring average on the team. And just like I mentioned with Ian, he continues to grow both in the classroom and on the golf course and continues to develop those leadership qualities that any team would like to have. Before I do go, I would just like to say that we miss seeing you guys on campus, and I'm glad I got this, you know, short time just to say a few words, and we'll see you soon.
First off, I'd like to send a big thank you to Jim Patrica for making it possible for us to still acknowledge some amazing athletes we've had this year. The fall was another successful season for the boys varsity soccer team, and I'm beyond proud to include the word another. Making the playoffs yet again and in the A1 conference is very admirable. It's quite often we witness a school who managed a great season and then the next season they're rebuilding, people graduated, but with us, we've managed to build a program together that continuously brings success, and this is only 100% possible with the outstanding group of players that we have. Whether it be incoming freshmen or all the way up to seniors, all the boys have bought into our family's philosophy, and it's something I cannot be more proud of. Over the last several years, Coach Burrell and I have been what feels like the luckiest coaches on earth. Not only because of the blessing of talent we've had, but also the character that the boys have. This year, I know it's going to be hard on the senior class with the current situation we're facing, but I'm pleased to say that they completed their final soccer season, setting a great example and standard for the returning students. I'd like to acknowledge our award winners as well, and this is the third year in a row that we've included four first-time winners, proving we always bring a team effort. Our all-conference athletes include Captain David Cardoza, second-year winner Cameron Toy, and junior Tyler Costin. Our all-conference honorable mention, and also captain and team MVP, was junior Eric Ponyman, and our all-county and most improved player was junior Josh Cabahug. Captains Dylan Dotan and William Wu, along with other seniors, left the team in great form to carry on, and I can only hope for anything similar to continue moving forward. I will forever be thankful for what these boys gave to the program, and I wish them all the very best success in the future.
Girls varsity soccer had a great season this year. We finished third in our conference with an overall record of 10-4. We only dropped games to two very talented teams, both Valley Stream Central and Clark. So we really did hold our own during this season with very competitive games that could have really went either way. We were honored to be recognized by the Nassau County Referees Association for being named the 2019 recipient of the Sportsmanship Award. The way that all you girls handle yourselves on the field and off of the field really is just something that myself, Coach Lanuto, and Coach Bazilia could not be prouder of. So well deserved, ladies. This year we'll be losing five seniors. Katrina O'Shea, who received all-conference this season. Mary Tahas, who was recognized as scholar-athlete. Kat Antonopoulos, who was our Coach's Award recipient in the fall. Irene Kateas, and Nicole Marakovich. Girls, we're gonna miss you so terribly next year. I can't wait to hear how college is and how you're doing. I know all of you will kick butt in whatever it is you set your goals on. So just remember to work hard, and we're always here for you to come visit and ask for any advice or anything too. Really, we're gonna miss all of you. This year, our MIP goes to a senior. She played in all 14 games. She had 8 goals, 2 assists. She was a force to be reckoned with in the center of our field. She was strong. She was aggressive. Other teams all knew to watch out for her. She really stepped up from last year to her senior year, really becoming a key player to lead our team both on and off of the field. So our MIP, I'm proud to say, is Katrina O'Shea. So congrats, Katrina. Our MVP, she also played in all 14 games. She had 6 goals and 1 assist, which is awesome because she was our sweeper. She scored off a corner kick. She scored off multiple direct kicks. I'm so happy to be having her back next year. Our MVP is Maria Dulis. So congrats, Maria. Awesome season, girls. Congrats tonight to all of the athletes, especially the senior athletes. This is not how we wanted to have this award ceremony, but we could not be prouder. I think all coaches feel the same way. We could not be prouder of you. I wish you the best of luck in your next chapter, and let's just all try and stay Herrick strong.
Tonight, I'm very proud to celebrate Herrick's varsity girls swim team. It's a bittersweet time watching these wonderful senior girls start their next journey onto college, which I know will be a wonderful place for them because they are leaders, they are loyal friends, and they are incredible athletes. Our team will not be the same without them next year. This year, all of our senior girls were captains on our team. They used their knowledge of swimming to push those who needed help, They created an environment full of support and laughter, and they continually made me proud through their work ethic and sportsmanship. As a first-year coach for this team, I was honored to be accepted into their tight-knit family of swimmers and incredibly proud of their accomplishments through personal best times, amazing races, division and county honors, as well as state recognition. I'm happy to say that not only did they excel in the pool, but they also earned scholar athlete team status. The team and myself will truly miss these six seniors, not only for their athletic ability, but for what wonderful friends they have been. Please join me in recognizing our senior varsity swim team members, Jenna Chin, Gianna Germano, Catherine Hung, Caitlin Shi, Nicole Nowak, and Aparna Verma. Our season was filled with amazing individual races and incredible relays. During the postseason, we had several swimmers qualify in the top 10 in Nassau County in their events. The following swimmers were recognized by Nassau County for their achievements and also qualified for the New York State Swim Meet: Kaylee Simons, Catherine Hung, Caitlin Shi, Nicole Nowak, and Sophia Karras. Sophia Karras also received honors for her time at the New York State Meet in the 500-yard freestyle. She came in second place overall in the New York State Public High School Athletic Association, and we're all very proud of her. This year's most improved player is an individual who was determined but not always confident in her ability. When placed in an event that she was not at all familiar with, she rose to the occasion even though she wasn't sure it would work out. Transitioning from a sprint swimmer to a long distance swimmer is no easy feat, but this team member enjoyed the process and surprised everyone, including herself. By the end of the season, this new 500 swimmer had dropped over a minute in her race time and finally realized that she has what it takes. It gives me great pleasure to present the Herricks Girls Varsity Swim Team Most Improved Player, Abby Wu. Our most valuable player did it all. When I first placed her in her assigned races during our first meet, she quickly said, "Coach, this isn't my race, but I'll do it if it'll help." Throughout the season, she dominated in any event she swam, no matter the stroke or distance. For the New York State Swim Meet, she qualified for four events, which is the maximum number of events a swimmer can compete in. Next year, she will be attending Northeastern University, where she will be a member of their swim team. This year's most valuable swimmer is Catherine Hung. Congratulations on an amazing season, girls. I can't wait to see what you do in the future.
Tonight is about the athletes at Herricks High School. All of the young women on the tennis team this year demonstrated self-reliance and drive. You all played with conviction. The skills you learned for the court also translate to life away from tennis. I hope that you will continue to use these tools, especially during this new normal that we are living in. This is a bittersweet moment. While I don't want to say goodbye, I am extremely excited to see what these young women continue to accomplish. To my exemplary seniors, Emily Tucker, Jessica Wang, and Gabriela Dos Santos, I look forward to hearing all about your upcoming adventures. Thank you for your openness to helping your teammates, your dedication to the game, and for your positive impact on the Herricks community. This year, our team shined on the court. We enjoyed success in the postseason playoffs. It was a first-time experience for all of us. Some team members enjoyed individual success as well. The following members were recognized for their achievements on the court: Jessica Wang and Angel Walia for all conference, Chloe Kim, Celeste Zhang, and Angel Walia for all division, and Gabriela Dos Santos for her sportsmanship. Congratulations to all of you and all the members of Herricks Varsity Tennis. There are two individuals that I would like to highlight this year, the recipients of the Most Improved Player and the Most Valuable Player Awards. This year's Most Improved Player Award goes to a spunky sophomore who is a natural athlete finding her stride in the tennis world. She is the epitome of a team player, strategizing with her partner, looking for ways to improve her game, and acting as a steady stream of support on the court. She is a genuinely caring individual who is motivated to improve the quality of her game, whether it is her volley, serve, stroke, or footwork. She is open-minded to learning new techniques, and she always gives it her all. It is with great pleasure that I present our Most Improved Player Award to Joyce Kang. This year's Most Valuable Player found success, both as an individual and as a seasoned and strategic doubles partner. Her competitive attitude, patience, and consistency and ability to overpower her opponents helped lead them to victory. This individual's powerful baseline shots, overheads, and spin serves placed her opponent on the defense. She was a champ at net and able to punch the ball at an angle to make a winning shot. While she brought intensity to her matches, she also continues to exemplify leadership off the court. This senior is a compassionate representative of Herricks High School, always ready to lend a helping hand. With that, I am proud to present our Most Valuable Player Award to Emily Tucker. Congratulations to both Emily and to Joyce, the entire girls varsity tennis team. Stay safe and remain healthy.
The Herricks boys volleyball team had a very challenging season. Right from the start, it was going to be an uphill battle as we were placed in the top division in Nassau County, playing against teams that continually win the county championship. That being said, we won some very hard-fought matches, and I think the most impressive accomplishment we had this season was taking sets off of both county champions. So that's a testament to the hard work that our team put in and the fact that we definitely belonged in this top conference. Unfortunately, we do have to say goodbye to a lot of seniors, and these seniors have been with the program for pretty much the last 6 years, most of them. Those seniors are Doreen Shivdasani, Matt Strokia, Andrew Brawa, Mac Michalik, Gerard Rosario, Griffin Zambell, Danny Vargas, Ted Kim, and our Coach's Award recipient, Virag Shah. Like I said, I coached many of them in middle school, and they're definitely going to be missed. As a result of our success, we did have four county award recipients. Those were junior Naman Kapoor and seniors Andrew Brawa and Danny Vargas. The three of them were named to the all-conference team. Danny is a two-time all-conference member, and we also had an all-county member, Ted Kim. Ted also represented Herricks at the Exceptional Seniors game, and Ted will be playing volleyball next year at Springfield College in Massachusetts. The most improved player this season was a tough decision. As our team has improved over the course of the last bunch of years, so have the players who were on that team, including many of the seniors that I just mentioned. But there was one player who pretty much stood above the rest. This player was a three-year varsity player, but he has played volleyball whenever he can. He has played club volleyball, he plays in the park, he comes to all our open gyms. This player has had the drive and the will and desire to improve every single season. He got himself to a point where he is actually one of the top setters in the county. Unfortunately, mid-season, he suffered an injury to his finger, which is not great for a setter, and this player was forced to miss most of the remainder of the season. However, he did work hard to get back, and he was able to play in our playoff match Unfortunately, we came up a little short against the tough Syosset team, but this player put us in a position where we could definitely win that match. That is the reason why Danny Vargas is our most improved player. Now to the most valuable player. This one was a little bit of an easier decision. Although we did have many players who were capable, as you saw from our county award winners, one player pretty much stands above the rest. This player was our top server, a very aggressive jump server, one of our better passers, and was actually one of the best hitters in Nassau County. Even playing against the top teams in the county, this player was always one of the best players on the court. That is why our most valuable player recipient this season, without a doubt, is Ted Kim. Lastly, I just want to say thank you to all of the seniors. You will definitely be missed, but I know you'll be back soon enough at our open gym sessions. You always come back and visit. And to the other Herricks volleyball players, I cannot wait to get back on the court with you, hopefully sooner than later, so we can improve on this season and look forward to a great season next year. Thank you very much. Have a good night, everyone.
Hello, Highlander athletes. Hope you're all staying Herricks strong. These are unusual times, but I know you will rise up to the challenge and be better on the other side of the situation. This is what being an athlete is all about, facing adversity and meeting the challenges and defeats of a season and still push it forward. Learning how to navigate with the successes and failures is one of the most valuable skill sets that being an athlete can teach you. I am so very proud to have worked with the girls varsity volleyball team this year. They're an amazing bunch of girls that were an absolute pleasure to coach this year. Each and every one of you young ladies really shined this season and brought so much to the table. Thank you to my assistant coach, Martina Finn, for her endless support and her magical ability to always stay calm, as well as our JV coach, Chrissy Silk, and the JV team that brought the energy and fun to the game every day. This year, the girls' varsity volleyball team competed in a very competitive league. The team did an incredible job of containing their opponents and had a very successful season, finishing with an incredible record of 14-2, capturing the co-conference title. Moving into the playoffs, we competed as best we could. However, we fell to the reigning champs of Nassau County versus Massapequa, but it was an incredible effort. Although we have seen our struggles during the season, the unwavering attitudes and unbroken spirits of this year's team was an amazing experience to witness and be a part of. We hosted our annual friendship tournament and our Dig Pink Night with an overwhelming success, making money to support breast cancer research and donated over $2,100 to the Side Out Foundation. I can't help being a bit sad as this year comes to a close, as we are parting with seven seniors who will be moving on this year to conquer new challenges. Tri-captains Rachel Saji, Gracie Bravo, and Lauren Levine. Other contributing seniors, Janine Fellis, who is this year's recipient of the Coaches Award, Olivia DeWalters, Franny Hackenjoes, and Gabby Zambell. Their focus, drive, and passion was incredible. Go after your dreams, girls, and don't let people put boundaries in front of you. Set your own limits and shoot for the moon, for at least if you miss, you'll be amongst the stars. Other postseason recipients this year included Lauren Levine, got Scholar Athlete in All-Conference, Emma Joseph received the Scholar Athlete, Michaela Eisinger, All-County Honorable Mention, Rachel Saji and Madison Carson both received All-County Awards. And now for the MIP, the Most Improved Award. This is no easy feat for any coach to choose one person who stood out, especially if they didn't get the accolades as some of their peers. But this promising star has already put in time to the team and has worked extremely hard this season. Her spirit was strong and her attitude was lively. She was a great teammate on and off the bench, offering support to her teammates. In addition, she had many positive contributions when she got in the game, serving strong and coming up with some huge saves this season. This award is going to someone who gave 100% of themselves, whose intensity on and off the court matched the energy they gave day in and day out. I look forward to hearing from her next year and all that she is doing. This year's Most Improved Award goes to Gracie Bravo. The next award is the Most Valuable Player Award. This is a young lady who is athletically blessed. She is a natural athlete. She picks up techniques and skills quickly and makes things look easy. When she is on the court, she is a fierce competitor, pushing herself and her teammates to raise the bar. She has played middle for the past 3 years, lending her help in any way possible to her team. Another step closer to victory. She is the glue of our team, physically and spiritually. Her teammates relied on her leadership and calm demeanor on the court to compete ferociously. She didn't disappoint her teammates or the coaching staff. She received an all-county award this year in the postseason. This year's recipient has miraculously received the award last year as a junior. She is one of the team's leading court players, leading in blocks, kills, and service points. This year's most valuable player is Rachel Saji. Have a great end of the year. Miss you, girls. I love you, and please stay in touch.
I want to start with the 10 seniors who are graduating starting their new journey in life. Although we are in tough times right now, memories last forever. And because of your hard work and dedication, we can always look back and remember the great times we've had at homecoming, football games, and basketball games, and for some of you, your competition season. I had the honor to watch each one of you grow into a beautiful young lady and talented cheerleaders. Even though your senior year was cut short, we must always think positive and stay grateful for our loved ones and our health. As a team, we must remember hard times make us stronger and to appreciate all of the memories we've made together. I would like to point out our captains this year, seniors Melanie Rodriguez and Julia Bonelli, and our junior captain, Ali Esposito. You ladies took on a role as captain, which is never an easy role. Keeping healthy communication between a team of 24 girls is not easy, but you ladies did an amazing job. You three are the true definition of leaders, and I am grateful to have met such positive, well-rounded, understanding student athletes in my career as a coach. Good luck to all my seniors in their years ahead. Starting with our fall most improved is a sophomore who has improved so much with one season. She tried a new position on the mat, which may be one of the most scariest positions as a cheerleader. But the reason she did it was to help her team grow and gave more opportunities for everyone to participate. She never complained and was always willing to do what was asked. This athlete has learned to combine strength and technique from each position that she learned. We are so proud of how far you have come as a cheerleader. We cannot wait to see what is in store for you next season. Katie Kofi, congratulations on earning Most Improved this fall season. This year's fall Most Valuable Player is a cheerleader that was always there to catch a flower when they fell. When I first met this athlete as a freshman, she was eager to learn and ready to take risk. As she got older, she became even more eager and risky, ready to work with no excuses. The energy she brought with her to each practice, each game, each competition is something that the whole team felt, and ready and willing to try new stunts and step out of her comfort zone, especially when focusing on the dancing portion. She is always ready to break it down front and center. I am proud of the lady you have grown into over the years. Isabella Da Silva, congratulations on earning Fall's Most Valuable Player Award.
I'm Mr. Barricaldo, coach of the Herricks High School first ever boys badminton team. Tonight, it gives me great pleasure to announce some awards for some of our amazing athletes on the boys badminton team. I can't help to be a bit sad because we will be saying goodbye to a great group of seniors. These seniors day in and day out gave it their all in order to make everyone on the team feel comfortable and really were there for each other throughout the season. I'd really like to honor these seniors. I know it's a little different that we'll be commencing these awards in such a fashion, but I'd like to honor these 9 boys: Ethan Fang, Manfred Fong, Nitin Korup, Thomas Lai, Jason Lee, Jonathan Lee, Tyler Lee, Jack Ma, and Jesse Wang. This was the first ever boys badminton season, and I have to stress it was an absolute pleasure having each and every single one of these boys on the team, not just the seniors, every single one. Each day of practice or on game day, it was an absolutely exciting one, full of laughs, sweat, and just a lot of fun. This year's most improved player. From day one, I noticed a lot of talent in all these boys, but this one really stood out. And as the season went on, day in and day out, he displayed so much growth. Another reason why I chose him as a team captain as well. He showed me a conditioning that he was willing to put in the work required to really lead by example. This year's most improved player, I'd like to honor Jason Lee. Moving on to our most valuable player, simply put it, he did it all, from conditioning, from tryouts, and his eclectic taste in music. He really was the full package. Day in and day out, he gave it his all at practice. He was funny, and he really just displayed positivity for the whole team. In those tough situations, we were always counting on this individual to give it his all. This year's most valuable player is Leo Yang. Thank you so much, guys. It's been an absolute pleasure. Can't wait to see you all in the fall.
All coaches have told me the same thing about the recipient of this award. He's a great competitor, he's extremely determined, and he's a true gentleman. This individual is the ultimate team member. He always gives 110%, he is coachable, and is extremely respectful, win or lose. If his team is up 15 points or down 15 points, his affect remains consistent. He is well-liked, and he's respected by all. The male recipient of the 2020 Outstanding Sportsmanship Award is Matthew Polo. The female recipient of this award is a three-sport athlete whom coaches describe as a hard worker who always brings positive energy to her teams. This individual leads by example and motivates fellow teammates by how hard she pushes herself. Her demeanor is always positive and encouraging, all while still being intense and passionate. All these attributes, plus her incredible smile and warm personality, make her the perfect candidate for this award. The female recipient of the 2020 Outstanding Sportsmanship Award is Ekaterina Antonopoulos.
This year, we will be saying goodbye to an individual who has been a fixture in Herricks for the past 3 decades. Diane Passettieri has mentored some fine athletes as well as some fine coaches. Perhaps her strongest attribute is her character. She is one of the most professional and highly organized educators and coaches we have had the pleasure of working with. Over the years, she has coached numerous sports, but is most well known as the Herricks varsity softball coach for over 2 decades. Most important, though, is the thousands of lives she has touched along the way. We are saddened to see Diane Passettieri retire, but honored to present her with a plaque which reads, Diane Passettieri, educator, coach, friend. Thank you for making a difference.
Being a Herricks Iron Man or Iron Woman is perhaps one of the most challenging feats one may tackle. A three-sport athlete basically has no downtime during the entire school year. They are practicing and competing from late August through June, and they must find the time to complete the daily rigors of being a student in a blue ribbon high school. It gives me great pleasure in announcing this year's Herricks High School Iron Men and Iron Women.
Our winter's most improved player is a senior who has shown her dedication to Herricks cheerleading time and time again. Although her schedule got busy and hectic, she always made the time and effort to make a difference for her team. Both on game day team and competition team, she always came and gave her all. Starting from freshman year, she's always had amazing talent, but to see her peak at her senior year as a cheerleader has been an honor to watch. She took learned techniques and applied them to all aspects of her position as a Flyer. I'm so proud of you, Isabella Yu. I wish you the best of luck in college. Our winter's most valuable player, I must say, the student, is one of the most humble, talented athletes I know. She came to practice every day, ready to learn and challenged herself daily. She was varsity team captain for 2 years out of the four years of her Herricks cheerleading career. Comparing her talent from freshman year to now, I could not be more proud of how far she has come as a cheerleader. She has put her all into the sport she loves as well as her schoolwork, and I am honored to say I coach such a bright, dedicated, talented student athlete. But most importantly, she came into practice with an open mind and kind heart towards all of her teammates. She will be attending Adelphi in the fall, and I cannot wait to see the accomplishments to come in your academics and your cheerleading career. Congratulations, Melanie Rodriguez. You earned your role as most valuable player.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and senior athletes. I would like to take this moment to thank everybody that helps the basketball season run so smoothly in the Herricks School District. I would also like to thank my assistant coach, Darrell Wolf, my JV coach, Evan Rabinowitz, and my middle school staff of Mike Yu, Joe Welsh, and Doc Sinicori. The 2019-20 basketball season will not be defined by wins and losses. It'll be defined by our hard work, dedication to the season and the sport of basketball. Our season was highlighted by two league wins over arch rival Great Neck South and Mepham High School. We finished second in the Coaches versus Cancer tournament, and we raised over $600 for the American Cancer Society during that tournament. This wouldn't have been able to be accomplished without the hard work of our five seniors, whose dedication, resilience have helped this program immensely throughout their careers. Our first senior is a two-year varsity member whose dedication is beyond reproach, is senior Rupinder Singh. Our second senior was a captain this year. He's an all-conference selection. He received our coach's award in February, senior Jake David. Our third senior was a three-year varsity member, our point guard who made us go on offense and defense, senior Zane Mehman. Our fourth senior is our MIP, probably one of the hardest working kids and improved the most in all my tenure at Herricks High School, senior Thanasi Mamias. Our final senior is a three-year varsity player who improved every year. He was named All-Conference this year. He was a captain this year. He will be also honored by New York State as an honorable mention selection for our section. He is our MVP, senior Chris Cherizunas. At this time, Coach Wolf and I would like to wish the seniors good luck with all their future endeavors. We would also like to wish all the senior athletes at Herricks well going forward. And we would like you at this time to be strong and stay safe. Thanks, Herricks.
Hey all, Coach Goldberg of Herricks Wrestling. First, I'd like to extend my deepest sympathy and empathy to everyone because we've all been affected by COVID-19 in one way or another, and particularly our senior athletes. While your health is the most important thing, I can't imagine how difficult it is not to have that final chapter of your athletic career or your academic career to close out. With that being said, one thing that can never be taken away from you is the fact that you are part of such a special family and a tradition, and that is this Herricks community. As a former student-athlete here and now a coach, I can tell you it really is a special place, and the support that we get from everybody in the school building and the community is inspiring. So I just want to thank Principal Keegan, Mr. Patrica, Maria in the athletic office, Bruce in the busing crew, the grounds crew, the custodial staff at the high school, our parents, and especially you, our student athletes. We had a really successful season this year, and that cannot be possible without your hard work and your dedication, not just in school, but on the mat. So I just want to thank you guys. I'm just going to read off some notes here. We had a 9-2 record this year. We made the playoffs, I think, for the first time in about 8 years. And not only did we make the playoffs, but we went to the quarterfinals, so we finished in the top 8 of Nassau County. We had 14 all-conference wrestlers, so I'm just going to read through the names. Joseph Manfredi, who was a conference champion. Mike Manfredi, Kumela Reef, Aaron Cho. Senior Sal Poliafico, who was a conference champion, also a co-captain. Joseph Matei, who was a conference champion. Kaylin McCauley, Marcus Ozakowski, Cole LaRocque, who is a senior and a co-captain, Giorgio Sampariotis, Danny Matei, who is a senior and a co-captain, Matt Polo, who is a senior and a co-captain, Nate Dowd, who is a senior, and Ash Multani, also a senior. We had 6 wrestlers finish in the top 12 of Nassau County: Kumela Reef, Sal Poliafico, Joseph Matei, Cole LaRocque, Danny Matei, and Matt Polo. We also had our first county champion in, I think, 9 years, Joseph Manfredi. And not only was he a county champion, but he's also a state finalist. He finished 2nd in New York State. He's only in 8th grade. So it's something that we're extremely proud of and proud to be a part of. Our most improved wrestler, our most improved player this year, goes to a senior who throughout his career had to deal with injuries and setbacks, but he pulled it all together this year, and he had a wonderful season. He had a 28-15 record. He was a conference finalist, and he was an extremely valuable asset for us. So that's Matt Polo. So congratulations, Matt. You earned it, and you deserve it, and we're proud to give you that award. Our most outstanding, our most valuable player, our most outstanding wrestler, goes to Joseph Manfredi, who, again, as I mentioned, is only in 8th grade, took 2nd in New York State. He's going to keep going up, and we're extremely proud of him. To our seniors, Sal, Cole, Quinn, Ruiz, Danny, Franco, Matt, Nate, and Ash, we wish you the best. I want to speak on behalf of Coach Lamina and Coach Bianco. We are extremely honored and privileged to be a part of your athletic career at Herricks High School and the Herricks School District. We're going to miss you. We hope to see you. Definitely come back and visit. And now we'd like to welcome you to the Herricks Wrestling Alumni family. Thank you all, and have a good night.
Hi. On behalf of Coach Schubert and myself, I'd like to honor and celebrate the 2019-2020 Winter Track Team today. This team was a very large team. We had almost 80 athletes between the boys and the girls team. That's a huge undertaking as coaches, and it would not have been nearly as enjoyable if it wasn't for the efforts of our senior squad. Saying goodbye to seniors is always a bittersweet moment for anybody who works in a high school, but especially as track coaches. There's no JV and varsity separation, so we spent 4 years with the same athletes. And this year is no different. We had a phenomenal group, and unfortunately we have to say goodbye to a large group this year. So we say goodbye and best of luck to Saloni Patel, Sherry Shao, Alan Abraham, Harsh Agarwal, Jeff Chen, Manfred Fong, Riley Kiernan, Ryan Lee, Jared Martin, Chris Matthew, Bob Patel, Prit Patel, Viren Segal, and Hubert Zhao. Congratulations and job well done, and we wish you the best of luck. Before we move on to our most improved and most valuable, we'd like to recognize our coaches award that were honored early this year, Saloni Patel for the girls and Prit Patel for the boys. Thank you again and congratulations. Most improved. Most improved is an interesting award because that's all we do in track. That's our goal from start to finish. If you're gonna finish a national champion, that's great. If you're not, that's great. The whole goal is improvement. Of all the things we try to instill and teach as coaches, knowing that hard work yields results is probably one of the most important. and this is what embodies the most improved award. So today, for the girls team, we'd like to honor Sherry Shao as our winner for the 2019-2020 Winter Track Most Improved Award. Congratulations, Sherry. And for the boys, we'd like to honor Bhav Patel as the most improved for the 2019-2020 Winter Track Team. Congratulations. For Most Valuable Player, a lot of words get thrown around and used and abused in the world of sports, but somehow Most Valuable Player holds its crown. There's something very special about it because everybody knows it encompasses everything. So our award is no different. These athletes have really shown the dedication, the hard work, and the success that goes along with the Most Valuable Award title. So without further ado, we'd like to congratulate for the girls team, our 2019-2020 Winter Track Team Most Valuable Player is Rhea Resquina. Congratulations again on a job well done. It was a phenomenal season. Also phenomenal season for the boys, we'd like to congratulate Jared Martin as the 2019-2020 Winter Track Team Most Valuable Player. Congratulations to you both. And congratulations to the rest of the team on wonderful experience. And for those of you who are returning, we look forward to you next year. And for those of you who are leaving, we wish you all the best. Thank you again.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Kristen Silk, and I'm the girls and boys head varsity fencing coach for this past season and this past year. As of this year, this was the first team ever to be a fencing program at Herricks. So it was very, very challenging at first, but it was exhilarating throughout the rest of the season. And I know the team that I had could really say the same. We've all had so much fun together. We learned together. We fought off equipment together. And it really was just an incredible experience for myself and for my student athletes. So congratulations to you all. You really excelled as a team and individually. And I'm going to shout out a couple of players on my team that deserve recognition and as well as earn some awards. So first and foremost, I want to thank you to Sasha Stern and Nicole Marakovic for being my two managers on and off that strip. It was incredible. Your experience from even scoring to helping out with practices, the way practices were run, you were always there to help me and I really couldn't have done it without you. You were my two assistants and I couldn't have done it. So I really thank you so much. I'm going to move on to my seniors. I am going to miss you so much as well as the rest of the team. There are nine of you and my heart goes out to each and every one of you in these crazy times. And I know that you will graduate and have a great time over the summer. And in your futures, you're going to excel dramatically. And I really wish and hope you all come back to visit. Michelle Chu, Joanne Johnson, Ashita Kushi, Ravia Singh, Aparna Verma, Cindy Wang, Jeremy Lau, Kareem Ibrahim, and Brian Singh. Congratulations to all my seniors. I'm going to move on and talk about some awards that were given out after playoffs individually. I'm going to start off with my seventh grader on varsity, Om Thacker. He became fourth in the county overall for men's epee, and that was very rare, unseen, and just an incredible accomplishment. So Om, congratulations, you should be very proud of yourself. I'm going to move on to two all-county honorable mention players on my team. Eighth grader Justin Lau from Men's Sabre, incredible work. And Michelle Chu, senior women's epee, all county honorable mention, those two people. You did an extraordinary job and you should be extremely proud of yourself. I'm very honored to have been your coach. Now I'm gonna move on to my two all Long Island players, which means they were county championships and they became first in the island in their sword. In their weapon. So Jeremy Lau, congratulations, number one in men's saber, and a tremendous, tremendous accomplishment, especially being a first year program. I know you're a senior and I am truly going to miss you. Giovanna Lau, who is also Jeremy's sister, congratulations, came in first for Women's Saber, which is even more of an accomplishment to see you as a 10th grader being number one on Long Island. Amazing job. I'm going to move on to my most improved players, girls and boys. I'm going to start with my most improved girl. She was a foil and still is a foil. And she made it all the way past the playoffs and was totally inexperienced, has never touched a foil sword before this year, and really just with flying colors branched out and did amazing. So my most improved player goes to Brianna Singh, congratulations. And my most improved boy, fencer. This boy was an epe, always encouraging everybody, so positive, had some friends come by to help out the team, was just always there, and such a selfless person. And I think this award definitely deserves to be Brian Singh. So congratulations, Brian Singh. My two MVP awards for girls, I'm going to start first. Giovanna Lau, you deserve this MVP award without a doubt. I could not stop watching you. You're incredible to watch. You're fierce, powerful, quiet. However, you would always help your teammates out, and I truly, truly thank you for that. Congratulations. And my MVP for boys, men's saber, Jeremy Lau. How could I not? You were helping out the team from the very first day, making a PowerPoint about what fencing even is, about the rules, the uniform, the strategy along with it. And I could not have done it without you, Jeremy. And I'm going to miss you truly. And please come back and help out, because this season was incredible. Thank you to everyone for listening, and I hope we are all staying safe and healthy. Have a great night, Herricks.
Tonight, I'm very proud to celebrate Herricks Varsity Boys Swim Team. It was a wonderful first season coaching these boys, filled with laughs, amazing improvement, and incredible meets. I'm happy to say that not only did they excel in the pool, but they also earned Scholar Athlete Team status. I'd like to take a moment to thank our captains for all their hard work and dedication this season. Colin, David, Kyle, and Taryn, you guys were amazing and really supported all of your teammates. Thank you for your help. As our seniors get ready to leave us, I'm so grateful for the time I had with them, and I'm excited to see what they do in the future. So please keep in touch. We will truly miss these five seniors, not only for their contribution to our swim team, but for the incredible relationships they have created along their Herricks journey. Please join me in recognizing our senior swim team members, Eric Bijou, Taryn Chang, Benjamin Hannon, Colin Huang, and Jonah Samuel. The season had many exciting meets where it came down to the final relay. The boys' team stood by each other, cheered on each swimmer, and put 100% into each race. The boys came in third overall in their division and eighth place at Nassau County. In the postseason, we were lucky enough to bring nine swimmers to our county meet. The following swimmers were recognized by Nassau County for their achievements: Marcus Chow, Taryn Chang, Colin Huang, and Eduardo Santana. Of those swimmers, we had two qualify for the New York State Swim Meet, Taryn and Eduardo. This year's most improved player is a new member of the team. While he has been an athlete all his life, swimming never really crossed his path until now. With amazing determination, he always asks, "Coach, what does my stroke look like? How can I get more power in my kick? Does this look right to you?" He never stopped asking me for feedback and took every practice seriously. In meets, he swam any event we needed him in, even if it meant swimming his least favorite stroke. He came to practice with a smile and willingness to learn every day, and I'm proud of how far he has grown as a swimmer. It gives me great pleasure to present the Herricks Boys Varsity Swim Team Most Improved Player, Jay Chung. Our most valuable player was not only captain, but also an integral part of the team. Swimming is a valued aspect of his life, and he takes it very seriously, although he always has a smile on his face and is ready to make a joke. He's always there to support his teammates and has wonderful sportsmanship with opposing teams. This year, he swam as our lead breaststroker and on multiple winning relay teams. He qualified for two New York State swim meet events and finished in the top 20 in the 100-yard breaststroke. Next year, he will be attending SUNY Geneseo, where he will be a member of their swim team. This year's most valuable swimmer is Taryn Cheng. Congratulations on a great season, gentlemen. I can't wait to see you all next year.
As for the girls' bowling team, we had a tremendously successful season. The girls finished 10th place out of 40 teams in Nassau County, earning a spot in the team county tournament. Unfortunately, on that day, we came up a little short, but I know with many bowlers returning next year that we will be there once again to compete and reach our goal as county champions. Unfortunately, we do have to say goodbye to a number of seniors who have contributed to the bowling team over the past few years. Those seniors include Lauren Levine, Janine Fellis, Francesca Hackenjos, Olivia DeWalters, Anoki Ladhani, and our Coaches Award winner, Gabby Zambell. The girls team had two county award recipients. We had freshman Emily Wong, who was an all-conference bowler and finished the season with a 150 average. We also had junior Sophia Arcis, who was named to the all-league team with an impressive 155 average. As for our most improved bowler, this bowler was on the team for 2 years. However, as a sophomore, this bowler was one of our stronger JV bowlers, but when she came to tryouts this year, it was clear she was going to compete for a spot on the varsity team. Throughout the season, she continued to improve. She finished the season with a 120 average, but what makes her the most improved bowler is that throughout the year, she kept getting better. And this culminated with her best match coming at the county tournament, where she was, in fact, our most consistent bowler. I know this bowler will continue to improve next year as she's a senior and will be a major contributor on the varsity team once again. That's why junior Audrey Santosis is our most improved bowler. As for the most valuable bowler, this bowler was pretty much our best bowler all season. While we did have a number of very strong bowlers, she came out on top. She is also our most valuable cheerleader, as she is constantly cheering everyone on our team on as well as the other teams, which is customary in bowling. The best part of all this is she is just a junior, just like many of our bowlers that I've talked about winning awards this year. So our bowling teams, both boys and girls, are going to be a force to be reckoned with next year. This year's most valuable bowler is junior Sophia Arcis. I just want to thank all the bowlers for a tremendous season, and I cannot wait to get back to the lanes and bowl with you all next year. The boys bowling team had a season that can best be described as having some ups and downs, some strikes and gutters, and some what have yous. We finished 17th out of 42 in Nassau County, which is an improvement over the past couple of seasons. And we will definitely continue on this trend as we return a large number of our varsity members and our JV members as we continue to make a case to be one of the top teams in the county. We do unfortunately say goodbye to a number of seniors, including Marcus Ng, Nico Luguidis, Danny Vargas, and our Coaches Award winner, Gianluca Licari. As far as county award winners, junior Leo Yang was named an all-conference bowler, finishing the season with a 191 average. This year's most improved bowler was mostly a JV bowler for his first two seasons with the team. This year, from the first day of tryouts, you could see that he was going to be one of our top contributors on the varsity team. I don't remember his average from his sophomore year, those stats I have back at school, but I think it was somewhere around 120 or so. This season, he finished with the second highest average on the team with an impressive 170 average. The best part is he gets to come back next year and try to improve on that and be again one of our top bowlers. He is the most improved bowler because he has worked hard over the last couple of years, bowling whenever he can. That is why this year's most improved bowler is junior Gareth Correa. Our most valuable bowler was a sophomore when he came to Herricks. And his first season on the team, he took a stake as our anchor bowler. I think his average last year was somewhere around 170. This year he improved tremendously and he continued to be our anchor. And I know next year as a senior, he will once again anchor our team and lead us, hopefully, to the county tournament. Definitely a goal for all of our bowlers. That is why our most valuable bowler this season is junior Leo Yang. Thank you, everyone.
Hello, everyone. I hope everyone's doing well. I'm really happy that we get a chance here to honor our seniors here tonight. I know it's tough not being there together to all applaud them at once and hear that round of applause they deserve, because they've been great members of the Herricks community for a while. So I want to start off by saying thank you to Kat Antonopoulos, Katrina O'Shea, and Rachel Saji for being great student athletes over these past 4 years for us, and to their families for being very supportive and willing to help out in any way. You guys served as perfect role models in our clinics and summer camps, and for your younger teammates during the season. So I'm going to miss coaching you guys, and we've been proud to have you as part of the program. This season, we had two of our players recognized by the county, Kat Antonopoulos as our Scholar Athlete Award winner, and Sheila O'Mara as All-County Honorable Mention. We were also a New York State Scholar Athlete team. I also want to give congratulations to Katrina O'Shea. In March, when we had our winter season celebration, she was awarded the Coach's Award, which was very well deserved. This year, I want to talk about our most improved player who came into the program probably unsure of where she fit in or if she'd be part of the program. And her most improved status is based over the work she's done over those years. She came into the program as one of our best athletes, even as a freshman, but her basketball skill was undeveloped. And over the years, she constantly heard from all the coaches that she needs to have trust in herself. This year, she became someone we could rely on. I told her she was no longer someone who wasn't going to play, and that she'd have a role, and that aggressive, fearless athlete needed to come out. I think she actually did better than she expected in that role. So I just want to name this year's most improved player, who I'm sure will continue with the same success and hard work moving forward. And it's Kat Antonopoulos. Congratulations, Kat. This year, this is for our MVP award. This year we faced a number of injuries yet again, as a team and athletes were forced into positions to produce more on an everyday level. Our team MVP once again took this opportunity to thrive. She led our team in points and steals and led us down the stretch in all of our wins. She's constantly double teamed by her opponents and recognized by opposing coaches as a player to stop and someone to look out for. She pushes herself at every practice and game and continues to grow as a basketball player, athlete, and a kid, a nice young adult. It's my honor to announce this year's MVP as Sheila O'Mara. Thank you, everyone, and good luck and stay well.
The Highlander Award is given to select individuals who embody the true meaning of the Herricks Highlander. These individuals are multi-sport athletes who have been recognized by Nassau County and Herricks High School for their efforts in the athletic arena. They have enjoyed a productive athletic career at Herricks High School, often being the focal point of the many teams they play for. These individuals have left their mark in a land we call Herricks. This individual has been described as a calm leader who is poised under pressure. Coaches agree that her contributions to her team stretch way beyond the field of play. She is consistent as an athlete and in the manner in which she conducts herself as a teammate. This Highlander is versatile, often being placed in various positions for the three teams she's a member of. Gives me great pleasure in announcing the recipient of this year's Highlander Award, Lauren Levine. A true leader by example, this Highlander takes charge during all situations. Her strength resonates amongst her teammates and helps them rise to the occasion. She displays a thorough knowledge of all the sports she plays, which has led her coaches to seriously consider her as an additional coach. Her take-charge approach and the manner in which she competes make her a definitive choice for the Highlander Award. The recipient of this year's Highlander Award is Rachel Saji. Coaches count on this multi-sport athlete to come up big in tough situations, and he always delivers. Every year, his role has increased to the point where he has become the go-to guy for multiple teams. He is at his best in big games. Coaches and teammates have become accustomed to the clutch performances of this poised, confident leader. Please join me in congratulating the recipient of this year's Highlander Award, Chris Jarazunas. Coaches have referred to this three-sport Highlander as one of the toughest athletes they have coached. His toughness and grit account for his ability to compete at a high level for multiple sports. Students gravitate towards him. He mentors younger athletes and has an aura about him which inspires his teammates. This individual has been a fierce competitor since before the seventh grade. He always rises to the occasion. He truly epitomizes the Highlander Award. Please join me in congratulating the recipient of this year's Highlander Award, Cole LaRocque. The female recipient of this award is a true team leader. She has worked diligently at advancing her athleticism to the point where she has become the go-to person for the two sports she plays. Her coaches rely heavily on her, not just as an athlete, but also as a mentor to younger team members. She's often referred to as Team Mom. Always arriving early, always leaving late, this special person is the ultimate competitor. The female recipient of the 2020 Outstanding Senior Athlete Award is Katrina O'Shea. The male recipient of this award is the backbone of his team. Strategy and skill, coupled with his advanced knowledge of the sport and the ability to connect to fellow athletes, make him an unstoppable competitor. This individual is a Nassau County champion and is ranked number one on Long Island for his sport. The male recipient of the 2020 Outstanding Senior Athlete Award is Jeremy Lau. The female recipient of this award is a true team leader. She has worked diligently at advancing her athleticism to the point where she has become the go-to person for the two sports she plays. Her coaches rely heavily on her, not just as an athlete, but also as a mentor to younger team members. She's often referred to as Team Mom. Always arriving early, always leaving late, this special person is the ultimate competitor. The female recipient of the 2020 Outstanding Senior Athlete Award is Katrina O'Shea. James Lane Allen wrote, "Adversity does not build character, it reveals it." I think it was pretty obvious he was referring to the students of Herricks High School. This school year was suddenly taken from us. We were thrust into a world of which we have never been placed. Yet, through this unprecedented crisis, you all rose to the occasion. Now tonight we recognize the achievements of a number of students at Herricks High School. But I would like to say congratulations to everyone. Being a high school student athlete and being the parent of a high school student athlete is no easy task. To our seniors, in the fall of 2016, you walked through the doors of Herricks High School. Your impact was immediately felt. Your years in the Herricks athletic program seemed to have gone by in the wink of an eye. We have truly enjoyed having you as part of our lives. You have all been faced with insurmountable challenges, yet you met and conquered them. I'd like to personally thank each and every one of you for allowing us to join you in your journey. We will certainly miss you, and we want to wish you the best in your future. Congratulations.